L'analyse des flux de
The
substances
analysis
permet de
of
mieux
substance
comprendre
flows allows better understanding the opening
attachées.
Up of biogeochemical cycles and the challenges related to these. So let's take a look at the nitrogen balance of Paris. This nitrogen balance is for the current period and it's expressed in gigagrams per year. So what we see here is that urban nitrogen has two major origins. One, combustion in transportation, in the industry, in heating systems, and the food system for cities. So if we look at the first origin, what we can see is that the combustion process leads to chemical reactions that are going to change the non-reactive nitrogen in the air into atmospheric reactive nitrogen, which will be made up of nitrogen oxide, which is going to contribute to atmospheric pollution. The second significant and more complex item for nitrogen circulation in cities is the food supply chain. It involves a larger quantity of nitrogen than the one involved in combustion, and this is a quantity that represents all the food that we and that our animals are consuming in a city. But what we see is that part of this food is not included in human or animal metabolism because it includes waste, and this is related to the matter of food waste, which is a major challenge in cities at the moment and which is also of consequence for nitrogen. Another part of nitrogen that gets to cities is contained in wastewater because animal and human metabolism rejects a large quantity of nitrogen that was ingested. So nitrogen ends up in the sewers or in water treatment plants when they exist, which they actually do in Paris. So we see that water treatment plays a great role because it turns reactive nitrogen into non-reactive nitrogen, which is fed back in the atmosphere. However, we can see that there are three major nitrogen release sources as sludges, as releasing of processed water in the aquatic environment, and landfilling after incineration. These are major challenges for the recycling of nitrogen, because if we could avoid this waste, we could limit the nine plagues of nitrogen, which are so damageable for the atmosphere. And by the way, the recycling of nitrogen, of urban nitrogen, in the past was a very significant challenge in cities and more specifically in Paris. On this slide, you can see a graph showing the considerable increase in the recycling of nitrogen with a peak at 40%, which is huge if we were to compare that to the current recycling rate, which is much lower, because in the 19th century, recovering urban nitrogen was seen as essential for food production because we were short of fertilizers, the population was increasing, so increasing the yield was absolutely crucial. What we can see to the right is the composition of a very popular fertilizer in the 19th century. It's compost with fecal matter, urine, horse manure, and all this material being recovered in cities. So we see what an urban manure can be. So this can generate some hope with regards to the current recycling of urban nitrogen.